So the first example that I'm going to give is the idea around double counting. So let's assume that a farmer has 10,000 bags of maize, and he sells 50, and he sells all of them for 50 rand per kg per bag. Now he's going to get 50,000 from this sale, and then he sells this to a miller, who then grinds the maize into millimill, and then sells the 10,000 bags for 75 rand each. That means he's going to get how much? 75,000 rands. And then he sells the millimill to a restaurant that uses the millimill to make pap. And then let's say the restaurant sells the pap and yields 110,000. Now, if we want to, if we merely add these numbers up, we are going to do what we call double counting. Let me explain why. If you take the 50,000 that the farmer made and add it to the 75,000 that the miller made, and add it to the 110,000 that the restaurant made, you are double counting. So why am I saying you are double counting? Because at the end of the day, by the time we get to the tertiary sector, we don't have the maize because the maize is in the pap. We don't have the millimill because the millimill is in the pap. So if we don't want to double count, what we do is we take the 50,000 that comes from the primary sector, and then we add it to the value that was added to the millimill at the milling sector, which is the secondary sector, right? Where the miller ground the maize into millimill. When he was doing that, what was he doing? He was adding value to the maize, because maize to us human beings might not have as much utility as millimill, because the millimill, we just imagine if we buy maize and we have to make pap by ourselves. Maize doesn't have as much utility to us human beings as millimill. So for that, we need the secondary sector for them to grind the maize for us, so that we can then just take the millimill we make pap for ourselves. I think you get my idea. But you agree with me that millimill has less utility to us human beings than the pap itself. So some of us will then go to a restaurant and just buy the pap and eat it there. Obviously, you're going to pay a bit more. So for us not to double count, because if you take the 50, the 75, and the 110, you are repeating. So what they do is they take the 50,000, and then they don't take 75 from the secondary, because the secondary did not yield the whole 75. They added value to the millimill, which is actually worth 25,000, because the 50 is what we had with the maize as it was. But the value that was added to the millimill is only 25,000, okay? And then the value that was added in the tertiary sector is the 75 to 110, which is what, 35,000. So what we do is we say 50 plus 25 plus 35, then it gives us 110. Okay, do you notice that by so doing, we are avoiding double counting? Because us double counting, we will be adding what we have added already. Because the maize is in the millimill and the millimill is in the pap. So if we add them together, we are double counting. So, but I don't want to confuse you. In the exam, let me point this one. In the exam, the figures that we give you are value-added figures. So you don't do the substitution that I'm doing here, the subtraction that I'm doing here. You merely add them up. But the concept is those figures are value-added figures. That's why we even call it GVA, gross value added. So for you, you just add them up. But what we have done is we have done the value-added method. All right, I think it's clear. If it's not so clear to you, comment down below and ask me what I mean. If there's an angle that you think I didn't deal with properly, if you still don't understand, just drop a message in the comments below and I'll get back to you. Okay, let's move on.